She's not dead. She asleep. Jesus said the people who laugh at him, don't believe Jesus, what he gonna do to rise the door of Jairo, who the ruler of synagogue. You're not gonna die. I'm not gonna die. We're gonna sleep. We're gonna sleep like a door of Jairo. Jairo, who ruler of synagogue, had his only daughter 12 years old. She was ill. You know, we can imagine how he loved so much his daughter. And cherished her. She was only 12 years old. She dead. All right, I want to tell you the scripture according to Luke 8, chapter 52. A lot of people were following to Jesus on the way. He was on the way to Jairus' house because Jairus came before the feet. He knelt down at the feet of Jesus. Oh, Jesus, heal my daughter. Please come to my house. So Jesus, okay, I want your house to heal your daughter. You know, Jairo, we can imagine Jairo must have tried everything he could do to make her better, getting well, searching for good medicine, looking for and being treated by the good doctor, and even this soul, nothing worked. Instead of getting well, her condition became worse and worse. They may have come to the conclusion that she could not be cured by medical practice. Jairo might have been given up by medical treatment. Then somebody said, Jairo had heard about Jesus, that Jesus can cure every disease, any sickness. Jairo knew the news about Jesus, who is going to miracle and heal every people. Upon hearing that, Jesus could cure people all kind of illness, so Jairo went to Jesus the fair at Jesus' feet and plead regardless his position and his prestige and pride. But before Jesus arrived at the Jairus' house, daughter of Jairus died. Messenger from the Jairus' house came and said, "Your daughter is dead. Do not bother the teacher anymore. It is over. It is finished because she's dead." All right. I want to listen the Luke 8, chapter 51. It says, when he arrived at the house of Jairus, he did not let anyone go in with him except Peter, John, James, and the mother and the father. And Jesus arrived at the house of the Jairus. All family members were wailing aloud. According to the Jewish custom, rich Jews could hire some mourner. My country, Korea, used to do that. At their funeral. And some musician to play sad songs with their flute. By the time Jesus arrived, they had already come and were playing sad song with their flute. On the other side of the house, there were hired mourners who were wailing at the top of their voice, "Oh, oh, oh, this little girl died, oh God." Some they might have you like that. Jesus saw the house of was filled with hopelessness and sorrow. So he put them out of the house, all people who they cry in the morning. Jesus told them, "Stop wailing, because, listen, gentlemen." Jesus said, "She was asleep. She's not dead. She was sleeping." Huh? Oh. Yes. We will not be dead. We'll be sleeping like this girl. Yes. Oh, thank you, Lord. Then we'll be wake up when Jesus is coming on the cloud. Rapture, we'll be caught up with Jesus in the cloud. You know, to be asleep means to wake up again. It is true, isn't it? If you are asleep, you will wake up again. again soon. People around in the Jairus house who were mourning, laughing. They were mourning and laughed at Jesus. What they are saying, you can hear. Oh, the girl just died. Who's that guy? They are talking to Jesus. Who's that guy? Saying that she's asleep. Is he out of the mind? See, he might be crazy. Jesus put out those mourners, servants, and family, all members, and who spoke negatively. Why did Jesus do that? Think about that. Because they were laughing at him, murmuring among themselves, she's dead, and who is that guy, what can this man do? Can he dearly rise her from the dead? And he make the come to life? Does that make sense? Jesus may have healed a few sick people. They know, because they've heard before. But he cannot rise the girl. She cannot rise the dead man, dead person. Already she's dead. This is why the Lord had to put them out from the house. After putting them all out, he took the child. And he went with the in the place where child was. You know, if we experience God's grace and miracle, we must get rid of negative thoughts from our mind. Negative thoughts, get out. Take out the negative thoughts from our mind firstly. We must get rid of the thought that we cannot do. It is impossible. It is finished. Or I would rather die. We should get rid of such a negative thought God doesn't like. Never hold on this negative thought. Oh, hallelujah. I'm gonna tell the story, the guy who is the Lord. Beautiful hymn. His name, evangelist Daniel W. Wickers. He wrote the hymn titled Moment by Moment, well-known hymn. Everybody love. I love. You gonna love. In the civil war, in this country, he was wounded. His right arm had to be amputated. After the war, he was converted at the revival meeting at the Dwight Moody in Chicago. Even though he had only one arm, he had decided to serve his rest of life to the Lord. Being overwhelmed by the grace of God, Holy Spirit touched him. He wrote a poem confessing that the Lord was leading from moment by moment. His daughter put the poem to music and it became him we love. This song, verse 4, beautiful, beautiful song and words. Never or weak. He does not feel never weakness, never sickness that he cannot heal. Moment by moment, in who or in will, Jesus, my Savior, abide with me still, moment by moment, I am kept in His love. Looking to Jesus, till glory does shine, moment by moment, O Lord, I am thine. Never a weakness, never. Look on the Lord Jesus, moment by moment. Yes, we have to look at Jesus moment by moment, not time to time, not day by day, moment by moment. Never that he does not feel, never sickness that he cannot feel. Do not say, don't say, I couldn't do. Don't say, I'm gonna give up. Don't say, I had grown without the parent. Don't say, I don't have educated, no money, no job. Don't. Don't say negative words. Old age gone. Don't look back past. Your bright future is waiting for you. New life is waiting for you. Hallelujah. The world of Jesus Christ is the proclamation of the absolute hope we need. This hope that will lead to the eternal life. It is a message of absolute positivity. When we hear his message, we can rise from the place of despair. We can rise from the place of death, from the place of sorrow, from the place of the pain. Get up with the face. Get up with your family problems. Get up with your disease. Get up with your financial problems. Jesus will touch and hold your hand. Get up. Jesus said, my child, get up. And immediately the girl, Jairus' daughter, died. She rose up, she stand up. When he proclaimed, at the moment, Jesus Christ said, child, get up, stand up. He's not asleep. She is not dead. He's asleep. The Lord our God raised the dead. Jesus himself rose from the death, resurrection, giving eternal life to us. Oh, hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Give him glory. Oh, my Lord, my God. Yes, we possess eternal life. We rose up from the sin. He gave eternal life as a gift of God through his resurrection. As soon as we believe in Jesus, we live forever, forever, even though we die. No, not we're gonna die, we're gonna sleep. Oh yes, this is not end. This is beginning. This is only